Imagine for a second a skyscraper, the tallest skyscraper ever built, that's 100 kilometers tall. You could take an elevator from the ground floor of this skyscraper all the way up to where space begins, to a skybar, where you could look at the Earth below and maybe even be launched into space from there. It would enable the average person to get around the months, years of space training, and get to experience the majesty of space. This concept is known as the space elevator, and it's an idea that's more science fiction than anything else at this point. That's mainly because right now, there are no known materials that are strong enough to enable us to build into outer space. But what if that changed? What if a new material was invented and engineers figured out a way to make it happen? Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, will we ever build into outer space? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. This is where I ask you to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe, and let us know in the comments below a question you have always wanted to know the answer to. We will do our best to answer it in a future video. In 1895, Russian scientist Konstantin Tsiolkovsky envisioned what he called a celestial castle in space, supported by a huge tower. Fast forward to 1960, and Yuri Artsutinov, a Russian engineer, modernized the concept. Then in 1975, Jerome Pearson published a paper about a space elevator. Here's how a space elevator would look. Starting with a platform anchored in the ocean at a point on Earth along the equator, elevator cars travel up and down a thick cable using rollers or magnetic levitation to travel. With this idea, it could take 5 hours or less for the cars to climb up the elevator into space. Oh, and to top it all off, one of these space elevator rides would cost perhaps 1/100th of the price of sending a rocket into space with passengers. The only way we can currently get into space, spaceships, is pretty inefficient. In order for a rocket to be able to make it up there, it has to push against Earth's gravity and overcome atmospheric drag. Building into outer space would be a far more efficient, less expensive way to get there. So why hasn't it been done yet? I mean, come on, we are living in the most technologically advanced era the world has ever known. Why can't we have the space elevator? Well, the interesting thing is, there are currently companies trying to figure out how it would be possible to build into space. Thoth Technology Inc. has been granted patents to create an inflatable structure that goes up into the stratosphere. But the stratosphere is not necessarily considered space. It's only about 12.5 miles up. Space begins at an altitude of 100 kilometers above sea level, at a point called the Kármán line. Still though, as it stands right now, anywhere above 31 miles can only be reached with spaceships. We still don't know of any type of material that would be strong enough to support itself all the way up into space. Once you get up into the stratosphere, there's the jet stream, an air current that can reach up to 275 miles per hour. Even the best, most lightweight, strongest materials we currently know of could not support a tower like this. That doesn't mean, however, that that won't change in the future. In 2014, Penn State researchers announced that they had created diamond nanothreads in a lab. Furthermore, research is being done into the capabilities of carbon nanotube technology, and practically every month, there's a new milestone reached in graphene research. Carbon nanotubes are cylindrical tube structures made of carbon molecules that are at least 100 times stronger than steel. And graphene is the strongest material we currently know of. It's made of a single layer of carbon atoms, and it's 200 times stronger than steel, yet it's lighter than paper, and has extraordinary mechanical and electrical properties. There are visionaries who are working tirelessly on the concept of a space elevator, like Bradley Edwards, an astrophysicist who's been working on it since 1998, Michael Lane, founder of Liftport, a company dedicated to the advancement of carbon nanotube technology. Perhaps in the future, getting to space will no longer be something that only astronauts and trained scientists do. Space could be accessible to everyone. But as it currently stands right now, building into space just is impossible. How long until it could be, you ask? Well, actually, according to a new study, a space elevator could be built and operational by 2035. A report from the International Academy of Astronautics laid out the concept of a ribbon, less than a micrometer across, smaller than a red blood cell, but it would be able to carry up to 7 20-ton payloads at once. An anchor that weighs approximately 2 million kilograms would keep it grounded to Earth, and people could be sent up the tether to a structure in space. This space elevator could reduce the cost from $20,000 per kilogram of launch to as little as $500 per kilogram. Problem is, the substance required to create the tether has not been invented yet. Once it is though, a space elevator will be quickly constructed and subsequently enjoyed by all. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you check out our playlist, Biggest Science Questions, clickable on the screen right now. And you should definitely turn on those notifications so that you never miss a video.